Today, we offer at the Divine Lotus Feet of Bhagavan Sri Nityananda Paramashivam the Pratyaksha Pada Puja. Before we begin the Pada Puja today, we request all the participants physically here and online to declare the following statements with integrity and authenticity. If you agree to the following statements, please say yes loudly. I authentically cognize, which is internally processed, understand and declare the truth that cosmic energy exists. Yes. I authentically cognize, which is internally processed, understand and declare the truth that His Divine Holiness Swamiji is the Chinmaya Vigraha, the embodiment and representation of that very cosmic energy. Yes. I authentically cognize, which is internally processed, understand and declare the truth that whatever I offer in the Pratyaksha Pada Puja to His Divine Holiness Swamiji will reach the cosmic source of energy directly. Yes. I authentically cognize, which is internally processed, understand and declare the truth of Sohamasmi, that even when I worship, I am Him. Yes. Let us now enter the Pratyaksha Pada Puja. Please be seated in a meditative space of gratitude and deep restful awareness in your Ananda Ganda. We'll begin with the Sadguru Vandanam. Please take some flowers in your hands, hold your hands in the Atmanjali Mudra, and offer the flowers at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet at the end of the mantra.
Nityanandam paramasukadam kevalam jnanamurtim dvandvatitam gagana sadrusham tattvamasyadilakshyam ekam nityam vimalamachalam sarvade sakshibhutam bhavatitam trigunarahitam Sadgurum tam namami.
The next offering is the Guru Parampara Vandanam. Now, please take some flowers in your hands and offer the flowers at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet at the end of the mantra.
Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva Samarambham Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Madhyamam Asmadacharya Paryantam Vande Guru Paramparam.
The next offering is the Arunagiri Yogishvara Vandanam. Now please take some flowers in your hands and offer the flowers at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet at the end of the mantra.
Lalate Tripundri Nitilakrita Kasturi Tilakaha Spuran Maladhara Spurita Katigopina Vasanaha Tadhano dushtaram chirasiphani rajam chashikalam pradipas sarvesham arunagiri yogi vijayate.
We will now perform tattvachamanam, the ritualistic cleansing of the hands and the mouth. With your right hand in the Gokarna Mudra, take 3 sips of water, chanting the following 3 mantras.
Om Atma Tattvam Shodhayami Swadha, Vidya Tattvam Shodhayami Swadha, Shiva Tattvam Shodhayami Swadha.
The base of your right hand thumb, wipe your lips from right to left twice.
Umhamridaya namaha.
Wash your right hand with the water from the panchapatram. With the tips of your right hand, index, middle and ring fingers, touch above your upper lips and below your lower lips. With the tips of your right hand, index finger and thumb joined together, touch your right nostril, left nostril. With the tips of your right hand, ring finger and thumb joined together, touch your right eye, left eye, right ear and left ear. Wash your hand with the water from the panchapatram. With the base of your little finger and thumb joined together, touch the navel, right chest, left chest, and with all the tips of the fingers of your right hand, touch the top of your head, right shoulder, left shoulder, and the center of your chest. We will now perform Shuklambharadharam. Please take some akshata, the turmeric mixed rice, and a flower in your right hand, and clench both your hands in the Mushti Mudra. Tap the sides of your forehead 5 times as we chant the following mantra. शुक्लां भरतरं विष्णुं शशिवर्णं चतुर्भुजं प्रसन्नवदनं ध्यायेत् सर्वविघ्नोपशान्तयेत्.
Now we'll perform pranayama, the regulation of breathing. With the right hand thumb, close your right nostril and inhale completely through your left nostril. Close both your nostrils with the ring finger and thumb and hold your breath. Closing your left nostril with the ring finger of the right hand, exhale completely through your right nostril. Following these three steps of the pranayama, we'll be chanting the Samhita mantras.
ओम होम ईशानमूर्ताय नमः. ओम हिम तत्पुरुषभक्तिर नमः. ओम हिम गौरधेयाय नमः. ओम हिम मामदेवगुह्याय नमः. ओम हम सच्चोदातमूर्तये नमः. ओम हामहृदयाय नमः. ओम हीम शिरसे नमः. ओम हूं शिखाय नमः. ओम हेम कवचाय नमः. ओम हौं नेत्रेभ्यो नमः. ओम हस्त्राय नमः. ओम होम ईशानमूर्ताय नमः. ओम हिम तत्पुरुषभक्तिर नमः. ओम हिम गौरधेयाय नमः. ओम हिम मामदेवगुह्याय नमः. ओम हम सच्चोदातमूर्तये नमः. ओम हामहृदयाय नमः. ओम हीम शिरसे नमः. ओम हूं शिखाय नमः. ओम हेम कवचाय नमः. ओम हौं नेत्रेभ्यो नमः. ओम हस्त्राय नमः. ओम होम ईशानमूर्ताय नमः. ओम हिम तत्पुरुषभक्तिराय नमः. ओम हिम गौरधेयाय नमः. ओम हिम वामदेवक्याय नमः. ओम हम सच्चोदातमूर्तये नमः. ओम हामृदयाय नमः. ओम हिम शिरसे नमः. ओम हूं शिखाय नमः. ओम हेम कवचाय नमः. ओम हौं नेत्रेभ्यो नमः. ओम हस्त्राय नमः.
We will now perform the sankalpa, the conscious resolution. Clasping the akshata in your right hand, clasp your right hand in your left hand and keep both your hands on your right thigh.
ममोपात्त समस्त दुरिधक्षय द्वारा भगवत श्री नित्यानंद परम शिव प्रीत्यर्थम श्री नित्यानंदेश्वरी पराशक्ति समेत श्री नित्यानंदेश्वर परम शिव प्रीत्यर्थम च शुभे शोभने मुहूर्ते आद्य ब्राह्मणः द्वितीय परार्धे श्री श्वेतवराह कल्पे वैवस्वतमन्वंतरे अष्टाविंशतितमे नित्ययुगे प्रथमे पादे जम्बूद्वीपे भारतवर्षे भरतखंडे मेरोः दक्षिणे पार्श्वे शकाब्दे अस्मिन् वर्तमाने व्यवहारिके प्रभवादीनां षष्ट्याः संवत्सराणां मध्ये विकारिणां संवत्सरे उत्तरायणे श्रीलक्ष्मी वेंकटेश्वर ऋतौ मिथुनमासे शुक्लपक्षे चतुर्थ्यां शुभतिथौ स्थिरवासरयुक्तायां मघानक्षत्र सिद्धियोग विष्टिकर्ण एवं गुण विशेषण विशिष्टायां अस्यां शुभतिथौ श्री कैलासोन्नत द्वादशांत श्यामलापीठारूढ़ श्री मीनाक्षी सुंदरेश्वरा भिन्नस्वरूप परशिवपुत्र रत्नकुमार गुरुमन्यतुल्यावतार श्री पार्वती स्तन्यपान लब्ध दिव्य ज्ञान विश्रुत सकल निगमागम सारभूत द्राविड वेद प्रवक्त्र श्रीमत्परम शिव करुणा समिति गत मुक्तामय चतुरश्रेयान गीयमान छत्र चामर श्री चिन्ह काहलादि समस्त बिरडावल्य अलंकृत ज्ञान विज्ञान चक्रवर्ती सर्वजन संग सद्यो निर्वाण दीक्षा व्ययापवर्ग विश्रान जीमूत परमत कलभ केसरी शैव सिद्धांत स्थापनाचार्य श्री राजाधिराज पांड्य महाराज गुरु शबन शाक्यादि महांधकार निवारण ज्ञान भानु वीक्षणानर्हार्ह ध्वजोच्छेदन पूर्वक श्रीमद् वृषभध्वज स्थापक शैव समय कर्त्रे सर्वज्ञ पीठारूढ श्री जगद्गुरु श्री ज्ञान संबंध देशिक स्वामी वागीश सुंदर माणिक्य वाचक स्वामीनाम अवतारभूत श्री ज्ञान संबंध स्वामी पुनरुद्धृत श्यामलापीठ महासंस्थान ज्ञान साम्राज्य शासक सर्वज्ञ पीठारूढ तृणवत्युत्तर द्विशतम गुरु महासन्निधान कैलास परंपरागत सूर्यवंश सर्वज्ञपीठ सुरंगी साम्राज्य शासक महानिर्वाणीपीठस्य अष्टोत्तर सहस्र श्री महामंडलेश्वर अटलपीठस्य अष्टोत्तर सहस्रतम अष्टोत्तर सहस्र श्री अटलपीठाधीश्वर धर्म मुक्ति स्वर्ग पुरस्वर्णपीठस्य त्रयोविंश गुरु महासन्निधान श्रीमद् परमहंस परिव्राजकाचार्य वर्य सच्चिदानंद प्रणव स्वरूप श्रोत्रिय ब्रह्मनिष्ठ नित्योत्सव नित्य मंगल नित्य कल्याण नित्य रित नित्यानंद पीठ महासंस्थान महासिंहासन पीठ गत्रे कैलास पुनरुद्धारक जगद्गुरु श्रील श्री भगवत श्री नित्यानंद परम शिव श्री आनसंबंध देशिक परमाचार्य स्वामीनाम प्रीत्यर्थम तेषां पादारविन्दयोः भक्तिसिद्ध्यर्थं गुरुकृपाकटाक्षसिद्ध्यर्थं क्षेमस्थैर्यवीर्यविजय आयुरारोग्य ऐश्वर्यानाम् अभिवृद्ध्यर्थं धर्मार्थकाममोक्षचतुर्विधफलपुरुषार्थसिद्ध्यर्थं समस्तदुरितोपशान्त्यर्थं समस्तमङ्गलावाप्यर्थं भगवच्छ्रीनित्यानन्दपरमशिवप्रसादेन सकुटुम्बस्य ज्ञानवैराग्यजीवन्मुक्तिप्राप्त्यर्थं श्रीनित्यानन्देश्वरीपराशक्तिसमेत श्रीनित्यानन्देश्वरपरमशिव अवतारभूतश्रीसर्वदेवदेवीस्वरूप भगवच्छ्रीनित्यानन्दपरमशिव प्रत्यक्षपादपूजां चकरिष्ये.
Drop the akshatan flower on your right side and wash your right hand. Apauvasprishyam. We will now perform the Ghantanada. Now please take the bell in your left hand and ring it loudly above your heart level. As we chant the following mantra.
Agamartantu devanam gamanartantu rakshasam Ghantanadam karom yado devata ahvanalanchanam घंटा देवताभ्यो नमः.
Now we'll perform the Manasa Puja, the internal worship. Please take a flower in your hands. Hold your hands in the Kurma Mudra. Sit straight. Close your eyes and offer the flower at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet at the end of the mantra.
Om Hrit Padma Masanam Dhadyat Sahasra Rachutamruteihi पाद्यं चरणयोर्दध्यात् मनस्तु अर्घ्यं निवेदयेत् तेन अमृतेन आचमनीयं स्नानीयं तेन च स्मृतम् आकाशतत्त्वं वस्त्रं स्यात् गन्धः स्यात् गन्धतत्त्वकं चित्तं प्रकल्पयेत् पुष्पं धूपं प्राणान् प्रकल्पयेत् तेजस्तत्त्वं च दीपार्थं नैवेद्यं स्यात् सुधाम्बुधिः अनाहतध्वनिर्घण्टा वायुतत्त्वं च चामरं सहस्रारं भवेच्छत्रं शब्दतत्त्वं च गीतकं नृत्यमिन्द्रियकर्माणि चाञ्चल्यं मनसस्तथा सुमेकलां पद्ममालां पुष्पं नानाविधं तथा अमायाद्येर्भावपुष्पैः अर्चयेद्भावगोचरम् अमायं मनहङ्कारम् अरागम् अमधं तथा अमोहकम् अदम्बं च अद्वेषाक्षोभकौ तथा अमात्सर्यम् अलोभं च दशपुष्पं विदुर्बुदाः अहिंसा परमं पुष्पं पुष्पमिन्द्रियनिग्रहः दयापुष्पं क्षमापुष्पं ज्ञानपुष्पं च पञ्चमम् इति पञ्चदशैर्भावपुष्पैः सम्पूजयेत् भगवन्तं श्रीनित्यानन्दपरमशिवम्.
The next offering is the Upachara Puja, the external worship. The first offering is Asanam, the offering of the seat. Now, please take some Akshata, the turmeric mixed rice, and a flower in your hands and offer it at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet along with the mantra.
Asanam Om सर्वभूतान्तरस्थाय सर्वभूतान्तरात्मने कल्पयाम्युपवेशार्थम् आसनं ते नमो नमः. ॐ ह्रीं इदं सुवर्णासनं सर्वदेवदेवीस्वरूपाय भगवते श्रीनित्यानन्दपरमशिवाय नमः.
The next offering is Swagatam. Welcoming Swamiji. Now please take some flowers in your hands and offer the flowers at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet at the end of the mantra.
Swagatam Om Shantatvat Sarvakartritva Bhavo Paratikaranat शिव उक्तो महातंत्र मंत्र विद्विस्सदा शिवः तस्मै शिवाय गुरवे वीतरागकलाय वै अमेयत्वात्तनन्तोऽयं मजत्वाच्च प्रकीर्तितः ओम यस्य दर्शनमिच्छन्ति देवा स्वाभीष्टसिद्धये तस्मै ते परमेशान स्वागतं स्वागतं प्रभो अद्य मे सफलं जन्म जीवनं सफला क्रियाः स्वागतं यत्त्वया तन्मे तपसां फलमागतम् ओम ह्रीं सर्वदेवदेवी स्वरूप भगवन् श्री नित्यानंद परमशिव स्वागतं सुस्वागतं ते।
The next offering is Padyam, the offering of water to wash the feet. Now please take the Padyam water in your hands and offer it at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet along with the mantra. Padyam Om Yad Bhaktilesha Samparkat Paramananda Samplavaha Tasmaite Parameshana Padyam Shuddhaya Kalpayet ॐ ह्रीं एतत् पाद्यं सर्वदेवदेवी स्वरूपाय भगवते श्रीनित्यानंद परमशिवाय नमः।
The next offering is Arghya, the offering of the traditional bouquet. Now please take the conch in your hands and offer it at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet along with the mantra.
अर्घ्यः ॐ दूर्वाक्षतसमायुक्तं बिल्वपत्रं ततापरं शोभनं शङ्खपात्रस्थं गृहानार्घ्यं महेश्वर ॐ ह्रीं एषो अर्घ्यः सर्वदेवदेवी स्वरूपाय भगवते श्रीनित्यानन्दपरमशिवाय स्वाहा।
The next offering is Achamaniyam, the offering of water for washing the hands and the mouth. Now please take the Achamaniyam water in your hands and offer it at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet along with the mantra.
Achamaniyam Om Mandakinyastu Yadvari Sarvapapaharam Shubham Grahanachamaniyam Tvam Maya Bhaktya Nivedhitam ॐ ह्रीं इदं आचमनीयोदकं सर्वदेवदेवी स्वरूपाय भगवते श्रीनित्यानन्द परमशिवाय स्वधा।
The next offering is Madhuparka, the offering of the nectar and drink. Now please take the cup of Madhuparka in your hands and offer it at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet along with the mantra.
मधुपर्कः ॐ सर्वकल्मषनाशाय परिपूर्णशुधात्मकं मधुपर्कमिमं देव कल्पयामि प्रसीद मे ॐ ह्रीं एष मधुपर्कः सर्वदेवदेवी स्वरूपाय भगवते श्रीनित्यानन्दपरमशिवाय स्वधा।
The next offering is Gandhatelam, the offering of the scented oil. Now please take the Gandhatelam in your hands and offer it at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet along with the mantra.
Gandhatelam Om Sneham Grahana Snehena Lokanam Hitakaraka Sarvalokeshu Shuddhastvam Dadami Snehamuttamam Om Hrim Idam गंधतैलं सर्वदेवदेवी स्वरूपाय भगवते श्रीनित्यानंद परमशिवाय निवेदयामि।
The next offering is Snaniyam, the sacred bath. Now please take the Snaniyam water in your hands and offer it at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet along with the mantra, and please ring the bell as you do so.
स्नानीयम् ॐ
इदं शुशीतलं वारी स्वच्छं शुद्धं मनोहरं स्नानार्थं ते मया भक्त्या कल्पितं प्रतिगृह्यतां ओम ह्रीं इदं स्नानीयोदकं सर्वदेवदेवी स्वरूपाय भगवते श्रीनित्यानंद परमशिवाय निवेदयामि. The next offering is vastram, the offering of clothing. Now please take the vastram in your hands and offer it at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet along with the mantra. Vastram Om Maya Chitrapata Channa Nijaguhyoru Tejase Niravarana Vignaya Vasaste Kalpayam Yaham Om Hrim Idam Vastottariyam Sarvadeva Devi Swarupaya Bhagavate Srinityananda Paramashivaya Nivedayami. The next offering is Abharanam, the offering of the jewelry. Now please take the Abharanam in your hands and offer it at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet along with the mantra. Abharanam Om Sabhavasundarangaya Nana Shaktyashrayayate Suvarnam Bhushanam Tubhyam Kalpayami Prasidame Om Hrim Idam Suvarnabharanam Sarvadeva Devi Swarupaya Bhagavate Srinityananda Paramashivaya Nivedayami. The next offering is Gandha, the offering of the sandalwood paste. Now please take the Gandha in your hands and offer it at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet along with the mantra. Gandha Om Shariram te na janami cheshtam naiva cha naiva cha Mayani veditan gandhan pradigrihya vilipyatam Om Hrim Esha Gandaha Sarvadeva Devi Swarupaya Bhagavate Srinityananda Paramashivaya Namaha. The next offering is Pushpam, the offering of the fragrant flowers. Now please take some flowers smeared with sandalwood paste in your hands and offer them at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet along with the mantra. Pushpam Om Turiyavana Sampannam Nana Gunamanoharam Anandasauravam Pushpam Grihyatam Idamuttamam Om Hrim Etani Sachandana Pushpani Sarvadeva Devi Swarupaya Bhagavate Srinityananda Paramashivaya Vaushate. The next offering is Bilva Patram, the offering of the Bilva leaf. Now please take the Bilva leaf smeared with sandalwood paste in your hands and offer it at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet along with the mantra. Bilva Patram Om Amrudodbhavam Sri Vriksham Shankarasya Sadapriyam Bilvapatram Prayachami Pavitram Te Sureshwara Om Hrim Etani Sachandana Bilvapatrani Sarvadeva Devi Swarupaya Bhagavate Srinityananda Paramashivaya Vaushate. The next offering is Tulasi Patram, the offering of the Tulasi leaf. Now please take the Tulasi Patra smeared with sandalwood paste in your hands and offer it at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet along with the mantra. Tulasi Patram Om Namaste Bahurupaya Varadamurtaye Paramatmane Swaha Om Hrim Idam Sachandana Tulasi Patram Sarvadeva Devi Swarupaya Bhagavate Srinityananda Paramashivaya Namaha. The next offering is Dhupa, the offering of the lit incense sticks. Now please take the lid dhupa in your hands and slowly wave it towards His Divine Holiness Swamiji along with the mantra, and please ring the bell as you do so.
Dhupaha Om Vanaspatiraso Divyo Gandhadya Sumanoharaha Agrayas Sarvadevanam Dhupoyam Pratigrihyatam Om Hrim Eshad Dhupaha Sarvadeva Devi Swarupaya Bhagavate Shri Nityananda Paramashivaya Namaha.
The next offering is Deepa, the offering of the lit lamp. Now please take the lit Deepa in your hands and slowly wave it towards Swamiji along with the mantra, and please ring the bell as you do so.
Deepaha Om Suprakasho Mahadeepaha Sarvatastimirapaha Sabakyabhyantararjyotirdeepoyam pratigrihyatam Om Hrim Eshaddeepaha Sarvadeva Devi Swarupaya Bhagavate Shri Nityananda Paramashivaya Namaha.
The next offering is Naivedhyam, the offering of food. Now please take the Uddharini of water, the spoon of water, and hover it thrice around the Naivedhyam. Offer the water at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet along with the mantra. Please continue to ring the bell as you do so.
Naivedyam Om Naivedyam Vividam Deva Shakkaradi Vinirmitam Maya Niveditam Bhaktya Grahana Parameshvara Om Hrim Idam Sopakarna Naivedyam Sarvadeva Devi Swarupaya Bhagavate Shri Nityananda Paramashivaya Nivedayami.
The next offering is Paniyam, the offering of drinking water. Now please take the Paniyam water in your hands and offer it at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet along with the mantra.
Paniyam Om Samasta Deva Devesha Sarva Triptikaram Param Akhandananda Sampurnam Grahana Jalamuttamam Om Hrim Idam Panarthodakam Sarva Deva Devi Swarupaya Bhagavate Shri Nityananda Paramashivaya Namaha.
The next offering is Punarachamaniyam, the offering of water to wash the hands and the mouth. Now please take the Punarachamaniyam water in your hands and offer it at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet along with the mantra.
Punarachamaniyam Om Uchishtamapya Suchirva Yasya Smaranamatrataha Shuddhimapnodi dasmete punarachamaniyakam Om Hrim Idam punarachamaniyodakam Sarvadeva Devi Swarupaya Bhagavate Shri Nityananda Paramashivaya Swaha.
The next offering is Aratrikam, the offering of the Arati lamp. Now please take the lit Arati lamp in your hands and slowly wave it towards His Divine Holiness Swamiji along with the mantra, and please ring the bell as you do so.
Aratrikam Om Hrim Esha Deepa Mala Sarvadeva Devi Swarupaya Bhagavate Shri Nityananda Paramashivaya Namaha Om Rajadi Rajaya Prasajya Sahine Namo Vayam Vai Shravanaya Kurmahe Same Kaman Kamakama Yamakyo
कामेश्वरो वैश्रवणो ददातु कुबेराय वैश्रवणाय महाराजाय नमः कर्पूरगौरं करुणावतारं संसारसारं भुजगेन्द्रहारं सदा वसन्तं हृदयारविन्दे भवं भवानी सहितं नमामि भवं भवं भवानी सहितं नमामि भवं भवानी सहितं नमामि आराद्रिगं समर्पयामि भगवत् श्री नित्यानंद परमशिव चरणकमलेभ्यो नमः। The next offering is Pushpanjali, the offering of flowers. Now, please take the flowers in your hands and offer them at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet along with the mantra. पुष्पांजलिः गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुः साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। अखण्डमण्डलाकारं व्याप्तं येन चराचरं तत्पदं दर्शितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। अज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। अनेकजन्मसम्प्राप्तकर्मबन्धविदाहिने आत्मज्ञानप्रधानेन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। मन्नाथश्रीजगन्नाथो मद्गुरुश्रीजगद्गुरुः ममात्मा सर्वभूतात्मा तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। ईश्वरो गुरुराप्नेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। नित्यानन्दं परमसुखदं केवलं ज्ञानमूर्तिं द्वन्द्वातीतं गगनसदृशं तत्त्वमस्यादिलक्ष्यम् एकं नित्यं विमलमचलं सर्वधी साक्षिभूतं भावातीतं त्रिगुणरहितं सद्गुरुं तं नमामि। पुष्पाञ्जलिं समर्पयामि भगवच्छ्री नित्यानन्द परमशिव चरणकमलेभ्यो नमः। ॐ नित्यानन्दम्।
कर्णधार स्वरूप करित्या सर्वदर्प Oh, श्री श्री नित्यानंद स्वामी की जय।
As part of the Uttamottama Seva offered at the Divine Lotus Feet of Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Sametachri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva, we offer the Paramashivoham Oneness Capsule, the Paramashivoham Advaita Darshanam.
Devadevottama Devata Sarabhuma Khilanda Koti Brahmanda Nayaka Shri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Sametachri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva परमशिवोऽहं अद्वैतदर्शनप्रिया परमशिवोऽहं अद्वैतदर्शनम् अवधारय।
என்னப்ப நல்லவா என் தாயும் அல்லவா என் தாயும் அல்லவா தன்னை உணர்த்திடும் தியானம் அளித்தவா என்னப்ப நல்லவா என் தாயும் அல்லவா தன்னை உணர்த்திடும் தியானம் அளித்தவா எங்கும் நிறைந்தவா எண்ணம் கடந்தவா கொங்கும் அருமையா ஆனந்தம் தந்தவா எங்கும் நிறைந்தவா எண்ணம் கடந்தவா கொங்கும் ஆனந்தம் தந்தவா என்னப்ப நல்லவா என் தாயும் அல்லவா தன்னை உணர்த்திடும் தியானம் அளித்தவா எழாம் உடல்கள் தாண்டி நித்திய வாழ்வும் கண்டிட கேடான காலம் தன்னை வென்ற நீலை நின்றிட எழாம் உடல்கள் தாண்டி நித்திய வாழ்வும் கண்டிட கேடான காலம் தன்னை வென்ற நீலை நின்றிட சீரான பாவம் என்னப்பன் அல்லவா என் தாயும் அல்லவா தன்னை உணர்த்திடும் தியானம் அளித்தவா என்னப்பன் அல்லவா என் தாயும் அல்லவா தன்னை உணர்த்திடும் தியானம் அளித்தவா எழாம் உடல்கள் தாண்டி நித்திய வாழ்வும் கண்டிட கேடான காலம் தன்னை வென்ற நீலை நின்றிட எழாம் உடல்கள் தாண்டி நித்திய வாழ்வும் கண்டிட கேடான காலம் தன்னை என்னப்பன் அல்லவா என் தாயும் அல்லவா தன்னை உணர்த்திடும் தியானம் அளித்தவா என்னப்பன் அல்லவா என் தாயும் அல்லவா தன்னை உணர்த்திடும் தியானம் அளித்தவா எழாம் உடல்கள் தாண்டி நித்திய வாழ்வும் கண்டிட கேடான காலம் தன்னை வென்ற நீலை நின்றிட எழாம் உடல்கள் தாண்டி நித்திய வாழ்வும் கண்டிட கேடான காலம் தன்னை என்னப்பன் அல்லவா என் தாயும் அல்லவா தன்னை உணர்த்திடும் தியானம் அளித்தவா என்னப்பன் அல்லவா என் தாயும் அல்லவா தன்னை உணர்த்திடும் தியானம் அளித்தவா எழாம் உடல்கள் தாண்டி நித்திய வாழ்வும் கண்டிட கேடான காலம் தன்னை வென்ற நீலை நின்றிட எழாம் உடல்கள் தாண்டி நித்திய மன்னனல்லவா எந்தாயும் அல்லவா தன்னை உணர்த்திடும் தியானம் அளிக்கவா எங்கும் நிறைந்தவா எண்ணம் கடந்தவா பொங்கும் அருவியா ஆனந்தம் தந்தவா எங்கும் நிறைந்தவா எண்ணம் கடந்தவா பொங்கும் அருவியா ஆனந்தம் தந்தவா
The 1946 Great Calcutta Killings, Direct Action Day. Muhammad Ali Jinnah, leader of the Muslim League, announced on the 16th of August 1946 would be a direct action day and warned, "We will either have a divided India divided or a destroyed India." The proposal of Jinnah to divide India was rejected. The result was more than 4,000 Hindus lost their lives and 100,000 were left homeless in Calcutta within 72 hours. Philip Talbot, in his letter to the British Library Archives, London, wrote, "Bodies piled on pushcarts, bodies caught in drains, bodies stacked high in vacant lots, bodies, bodies." More than 4,000 people died and 11,000 people were injured in what is already being called the Great Calcutta Killing, or the Week of the Long Knives. This is the barbaric cruelty with which Hindus were massacred and their dead bodies dumped in drains and rivers. And this is why this bit of the history was deliberately hidden from the eyes of common people. As is yet unknown to mainstream population of Hindus around the world, Hindus of West Pakistan suffered terribly during partition and continue to do so. During the partition of India, there was an influx of 4 million people from India. More than 7 million Hindus and Sikhs were expunged from their homes in Pakistan. This was a planned move and an attempt at ethnic cleansing of Hindus and Sikhs from Pakistan. Loot, arson, rape were common. Trains were stopped. People in the trains were starved, shot, or stabbed. The entire state of Punjab was ablaze under the atrocities of anti-Hindu religious terrorists. The population of Hindus in Pakistan was 4.06 million in 1941, 0.44 million by 1951.
If you feel responsibility is a power, you make your life successful.
When life is poised on the verge of a breakthrough or a breakdown that threatens existence itself, the Supreme Superconsciousness, Paramashiva, descends in human form as an avatar.
Paritranaya sadunam vinashaya cha duskritam धर्म संस्थापनार्थाय संभावामि युगे युगे फॉर द अपलिफ्टमेंट ऑफ द सेंटली एंड फॉर द रिमूवल ऑफ क्रिमिनल पावर्स फॉर द एस्टैब्लिशमेंट ऑफ द इंटेग्रिटी आई कम इनटू एक्जिस्टेंस आई हैपन विद द फॉर्म इन एवरी एज.
Avatars embody the compassionate and auspicious intervention of Paramashiva to rejuvenate and expand life. Humanity is way overdue for the next breakthrough. Now, Paramashiva has descended again. Bhagavan Sri Nityananda Paramashivam is here for you. Just as the rain is drawn to the parched earth, He is drawn to our plane, compelled by nothing but boundless compassion to fulfill the longing of a million hearts, to blast through our impossibilities and re-establish us in a lifestyle of enlightenment. Resplendent with the Uttamuttama, the best of the best, He has a proposal for you. Will you become me? Blessed are we to have Paramashiva himself as Guru. On Guru Purnima, bask in his love and compassion. Open yourself to receive all he has come down to shower upon you. On July 16th, join us and celebrate Guru Purnima, the most auspicious day to remember Guru in your life. Offer Pratyakshapada Puja and Tulabharam. Receive the blessings of His Divine Holiness, Bhagavan Sri Nityananda Paramashivam.
Nityanyanamurtim Dvandvatitam gagana sadrisham Tattvamasyadhilakshyam Ekam nityam vimalamachalam Sarvadi sakshibhutam Bhavatitam trigunarahitam Sadgurum tam namami. Nityanandam, welcome all of you, all the listeners, viewers, Kailasavasis from various Kailasas all around the globe, tuning into Nityananda TV Live, Facebook Live, YouTube Live, and being part of this auspicious hour, Nitya Satsang, the direct divine audience with His Divine Holiness, Bhagavan Sri Nityananda Paramashiva Himself. Powerful cognitions. Understand what we cognize and have as understanding about ourselves. Whether it is your idea of life or idea about people around you or idea about God. All of these are influenced and influence the cognition that you carry over yourself. The cognition that you carry about yourself plays a major role deciding what kind of life you're going to be having? What is the quality of life that you're going to be enjoying? What kind of life you're going to be manifesting as your future? It is this idea that you have about yourself. Understand, everyone carries a particular idea, an inner image within them. Show themselves as something, would say, their outer image. Sometimes the inner image and outer image will be aligned. Sometimes they will not be aligned. Actually, most of the times, what you think inside, but how you show outside, will be completely different. And how others perceive you, the other's image, how you perceive life, everything around you, everyone around you, that is life image. And these four identities together make your cognition about yourself. Don't you give a beautiful definition? Authenticity is aligning all your four images to its peak possibility. Anything it might be, you have a satisfaction from it only when you do it from your peak possibility. Whether it is your job or your art, or a speech that you're giving, the satisfaction that happens in yourself manifests only when you've done it from your authenticity. Before we enter into finding, like understanding and cognizing what is authenticity, I would like to introduce to each of you about a very fundamental cognition. The idea that we carry about ourselves, the inner image, how we perceive ourselves to be, and outer image, how you show yourself to others. Inner image creates a lot of havoc, confusion, chaos, both in your inner space and in your life itself. The responses that you have for a particular situation, what makes something different? What makes whether a situation to be a problem or an expansion for you? It's only the way you respond to it. Understand the way the war has happened, persecution has happened for Swamiji. It is his response, the powerfulness that made the whole thing to be a victory on Swamiji's side and to manifest a reality that you can't even comprehend about. If somebody would have gone through the persecution like what Swamiji had gone through, I don't know even if they'll be alive. But not just being alive, not just running, the few campuses that was running at that time, but just expanding, exploding, and expanding in a very exponential way. That is authenticity. Anything you do, you'll get the best results of it only when you are authentic. When you align all your four images to its peak possibility. Now, what does it mean by aligning our four images to its peak possibility? Without aligning it, I do have friends, I am happy, and I have a lot of other things to do. Many of those things happen. But just take a minute. Look at the way how your life is running. Is whatever you want getting created as a reality? Is that manifesting as a reality? The thing that you perceive, Life would be so good if this happens. Is it manifesting that way? But in spite of you, you might be achieving many other things in the outer world. But you face something called as depression or success. The mental issues that current day humanity is facing, along with the delusion that the whole of humanity is getting into, it's just becoming more and more day by day. The whole issue is because the center, the core cognition, where you identify yourself, that needs a shift. Only when that shift happens, anything else in your life can change. Understand? Because after all, your response to the situation that matters. It is not about what the situation is, but the response to the situation. Understand? A potato and an egg. Both can be put in boiling water. Egg becomes hard, potato becomes soft. Disappears. It's your choice whether the situations that are happening in your life, you want to turn it as your advantage, or you want to turn it against you. Do you want to make it a part of your success story, or do you just want to become a failure? That decision is what you have in your hands. Understand this very carefully. Whether, anything meaning really any kind of reality that you want to manifest, just if you have that core cognition being established on something that can never be touched, which has assumed the form and come now as Swamiji. And from that core cognition, when you start perceiving everything which is around you, you'll just see the whole cognition level that you're stuck in transforms. The karma that you are struggling with for years now will just disappear, especially on Guru Purnima day. Swamiji will just burn all the karmas. The whole thing. So beautifully manifesting and happening. Life, the beautiful happening. Just the ideas, the cognitions you carry about yourself, which determines the direction at which your life will be running towards. Just a small change in that idea, that cognition, you'll simply see how everything becomes so beautiful and aligned to you. Today we have a very exciting thing going to happen. Right at a satsang, we are having Brahmotsavam invitation to Swamiji himself. So let us all now get ready, straight, and enter into the space of meditation and start chanting the Mahavakya Om Nityananda Paramashivam intensely from your Evil sent.
Shivoham Om Nityananda Paramashivoham.
नित्यानन्देश्वर समारम्भाम् नित्यानन्देश्वरि मध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्ताम् वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम् ऐ वेल्कम् आल् आफ् यू विथ् मै लव् अण्ड् ब्लेस्सिङ्ग्स् on this auspicious Guru Purnima day. I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis, Sri Mahans, Mahans, owners of Sarvajna Peetha, Tanidar Kotari, Balasans, Rishis, Swamis, Mahaswamis, Goswamis, visitors, viewers, everyone sitting with us from all over the world in Bididi, in all over the world from Bididi. From all over the world in Bididi and in all over the world from Bididi. I welcome all of you sitting with us in Rajya Sabha. Newly refurbished, inaugurated Rajya Sabha. I'm sitting with us through Nityananda TV, Sadhana TV, Ara TV, Nakshatra TV and two-way video conferencing, having Nayana Deeksha all over the world, cities sitting with us through two-way video conferencing, having Nayana Deeksha all over the world. First, Nityananda Nagara, Bididi, is offering 1008 Nivedyams. Oklahoma Adinam is offering 45 Nivedyams. Hyderabad Adinam is offering 108 Nivedyams. Kuala Lumpur Adinam is offering 108 Nivedyams. Toronto, Canada Adhinam is offering 108 Nivedyams. Houston Adhinam is offering 121 Nivedyams. New Zealand, Trinidad Tobago is offering 21 Nivedyams. Australia, Nityananda Sangha Australia is offering 108 Nivedyams. And Seattle is offering 65 Nivedyams, Seattle Adhinam. Ohio Adhinam is offering 112 Nivedyams. Nepal Dhyanapitam is offering 56,000 lamps and 56 Nivedyams. I accept the Nepal's 56 Nivedyams and 56,000 Deepas. I also commit on this day all the persons, animals, beings suffered during the earthquake. All of them will be liberated. I also bless this nation, come back to Hinduism. Let this nation come back to Hinduism. To honor this nation's decision to come back to Hinduism, this December, I am going there to conduct the inner awakening. All the parties in Nepal have decided to come back to Hinduism. I am so happy with the decision. To support the decision, give my moral support, I'll be physically going there and conducting the December inner awakening in Nepal. And I also wanted to encourage the spiritual tourism for Nepal, which has suffered due to earthquake. I am committing to revive it whatever way I can and support Nepal. Dubai Adiyanam is offering 16 Nivedyams and San Jose Adiyanam is offering 108 Nivedyams, and today my deity in San Jose Adinam is ready. Through this I energize and do the prana pratishta. Let the energy of Ellam Vallasuttar explode in San Jose. As Sadashiva, I'll continuously available, be available from that Murti to whole US. To mark the presence of Sadashiva in this murti, all the 5 sacred items, basma, kumkuma, turmeric, honey, and the sandal will materialize from now. It will start materializing from that murti continuously to tell people my presence. Anybody stares into the third eye of those murti, of that murti, their third eye will be awakened. In that murti, I'll always reside and be available as Sadashiva to the whole universe. Los Angeles Adinam is offering 116 Nivedyams. St. Louis Adinam is offering 108 Nivedyams. Oman Adinam is offering 51 Nivedyams. Mill Valley Vairavan Goyal is offering 21 Nivedyams. And Hyderabad Adinam, Oklahoma, all the other already read out. There are many more cities sitting with us. Houston, Texas, High Point, North Carolina, Phoenix, Kanchipuram, Baroda, Vadodara, Washington, D.C., Sripuram, Mill Valley, Vairavan Goyal, Selayang, Malaysia, Philadelphia, Trinidad, Tobago, North San Antonio, Singapore is offering 121 Nivedyams.
Kulim is offering 21 nevedyam, Pinang is offering 21 nevedyams, Vadodara is offering 26 nevedyams, Sun Prairie, Wisconsin. So all the cities I read out and which I have not read out, I accept all your offerings, devotion, Gurumudi, everything. So many more Adinams and Ashrams are joining. Uthai Adinam is offering 21 Nivedyam. Thiruvannamalai Adinam is offering 21 Nivedyam. I accept everything. And as a living expression of Adi Guru Sadashiva, I accept all this as a personal seva to me and bless all of you. Let you all achieve the ultimate along with whatever good things you need, you want, even in mundane world. My today's message, the Guru Purnima message, Guru Purnima 2015 message, Guru Bhakti. Understand this word Guru Bhakti. It is not just putting few flowers in his feet or doing some small puja. Of course, that is a symbolic representation. But the real Guru Bhakti, understand, being authentic to Guru. Let me explain that word, Guru Bhakti. Being authentic to Guru. Look into your inner image. See how much of your inner image is influenced by Guru's presence in your life. Look into your inner image. See in how much you are still stuck with your old stupid identity and inner image. How much the Guru has influenced, Guru's presence has influenced, and how much of your idea about you has changed. Please understand, your inner image is not you. Not only your inner image is not you, what you think as your inner image is a screen, iron curtain, stopping you to experience the real you. See how much your inner image has been influenced by your Guru's presence in your life. If you continue to have your inner image without changing, you are living your logical life. Yesterday you have been sick. Logically today you will be sick. Logically tomorrow you will be sick or more sick. Till death. That is supposed to be the logical life. Inspiration and energy of the Guru enters into your inner image. Life will not be any more logical, it will become just magical. It is not any more logical, it will simply become magical. How much your inner image is inspired, influenced by your Guru's presence in your life. How much your outer image is inspired and influenced, what kind of outer image you show to your Guru. And what, how your Guru holds you, what is the anyakara he is having about you, have you taken responsibility for it? What kind of a image you hold about Guru and the life around Guru, the Sangha. Understand, Guru Bhakti is bringing authenticity in your relationship with Guru. Let your inner image be as your Guru wants. Whoever considers me as your Guru, understand, whoever considers me as your Guru, for all of you, I am making it very clear. The inner image I expect from you, I want you to have the inner image of Shivoham. My taste is very simple in anything. I just want the best thing. My taste is too simple. Go on transforming your inner image every day, whether it is an inch or meter or kilometer or mile. Move towards Shivoham. That's the first step for any activism. Please understand. Any activism in your life, the first step is moving towards Shivoham. Align your inner image towards what your Guru wants as your inner image. How you project yourself to your Guru? Sit and align. Sit and analyze how He holds you. What is His anyakara for you? Are you taking responsibility for it? Understand, anyone who takes responsibility to align themselves to my anyakara, I commit with you. You experiencing Shivoham is my responsibility. As Sadashiva, I give you the boon of living Shivoham. When Guru ordains, He sustains. Understand. I never ordain anything which I cannot sustain. If I have told you, do completion for 3 months, I already sent the energy to do completion to you, and then only I ask you to do. If Krishna is asking Kuchela to do all the danas, whatever wealth is required for Kuchela to do the danas, Krishna has already sent to Kuchela's house. Only then He is asking Kuchela to do the danas. Understand, anything I ordain, I already sent whatever is required to you. I already sent whatever is needed to sustain it. Only then I ordain. Be a man to stand up to Guru's Anyakara. Impossibility is not cute. Impossibility is not cute. Nobody is here to celebrate your powerlessness. Powerlessness is not fashionable. Impossibility is not cute. Nobody is going to tell you, oh, how innocent and cute he looks. No. Shivaganas are the modern day fashion. Be a Shivagana. Gana means filled in length, breadth, depth. Let your length, breadth, depth be filled by Shiva. That is the meaning, definition of Shiva Gana. Let not any dimension of you be left without being filled by Shiva. Understand? Let your length, breadth, depth, all dimensions be filled by Shiva. Sada. That is the meaning of Shiva Gana. Remember, when Mahadeva ordains, he sustains. When Sadashiva ordains, he sustains. The living expression of Sadashiva, your Guru, when he ordains, he sustains. What is the influence of your Guru in your inner image? What is the influence of your Guru on your outer image? What kind of outer image you show to your Guru? And what is your Guru's Anyakara for you? How much you have taken responsibility, and what is your Anyakara towards Guru? What, how you hold him? What's your image towards Guru and life? Align all the four to its highest possibility, that is Guru Bhakti. That is Guru Bhakti. Whether you understand or don't understand, because you don't understand or you feel difficult, you don't want to clap, whatever may be your mind, this is Guru Bhakti. Understand? The straightforward sacred truths. There is no compromise. Fools are those who ask shortcut, because shortest cut is a straight line. Shortest distance between two points is straight line. Shortest cut between any two points is a straight line. Understand? Bring authenticity in your connection with the Master. Bring integrity with your words with the Master. Bring responsibility with your commitment with the Master. Only then you can enrich the world about the Master. Otherwise, your enriching may be hypocritical marketing to show you are trying to do something or maintain your position in the Sangha. Maintain your status in the Sangha, not the state. First, bring authenticity with your connection in the Guru, with the Guru. Bring integrity with your words with the Guru. Bring responsibility in your connection with the Guru. Only then you will be enriched by Guru's energy, and you can enrich the world with Guru's energy. Otherwise, you may be just eating kakka biryani. Means crow biryani. You may be thinking you are eating biryani, but end up in eating crow biryani only when you are belching, you will understand. Kaa, kaa. Guru Bhakti is the first step towards achieving anything, including enlightenment. Even to start the spiritual process, at least to start, maybe the first step, little bit of completion or yoga or meditation. Even for that, you need certain kind of a, at least basic trust towards Guru. The initial form of Guru Bhakti, and ultimately, even for enlightenment, Guru Bhakti is required. Guru Bhakti is required. Actually, Guru Bhakti itself is an independent method to lead you to enlightenment without any other technique or methodology. Without a need to move your body once or blow your nose even once or stare into the mirror even once or get into your past even once, without any technique, any method, just the Guru Bhakti alone is independently intelligent enough to lead you to enlightenment. I tell you, even after enlightenment, I realized the result of enlightenment itself is eternal Guru Bhakti, that's all. Actually, after enlightenment, what you are going to bring into you, what is going to be your foundation cognition, your basic cognition to exist, is Guru Bhakti. Guru Bhakti is not your whims and fancies towards your own concept of Guru. It is authenticating yourself, authentically aligning yourself, authenticating yourself and authentically aligning yourself to your Guru. By aligning your inner image, outer image, others image, life image with your Guru's connection, it is actually not difficult. I tell you, the other day one guy came and met me. Actually, even news article appeared about him in the Facebook and all. He came and met me maybe few months before. Actually, just within 50,000 rupee, he has made a helicopter. He's an Indian automobile mechanic. I was shocked. And it is really flying. Two persons can fly in that. I was shocked. How 50,000, what did he do? When I studied his inner space, he retained his innocence of, if eyes can see, hands can do. Which was one of the greatest teaching I received from my Guru, beautifully in Tamil. Kannu paaka kai seyyanu, adu danda manushan. Means, if I see, hands should do, only then you are a man. Actually, in one temple, suddenly on a festival day, Devi temple, festival day, the priest is not there to do the decoration, the sandal paste alankara for the Devi. My Guru and me, both of us went to the temple. Suddenly she told me, have you seen in the temple, the main Arunachaleshwara temple, they're doing the sandal paste alankara? I said, yes, I have seen, ma. She said, do it. I said, how? Then she made a statement. கண் பார்க்க கை செய்யணும், அதுதான்டா மனுஷன் போய் பண்றா. If your eyes can see, your hands should do. I tell you, that is basically the village Indian's belief about himself. It is actually the Western engineering education destroys you and makes you feel everything is difficult. Unfortunately, in India, everybody first becomes engineer, only then they try to figure out what to do, what to become. I actually don't read any English book other than the scriptures English translation, because I don't want to be influenced by that Western thought currents. I learnt English only by downloading the spiritual material. Not by reading any Shakespeare, un-Shakespeare, shaking beer or unshaking beer. No, please understand. When you read Shakespeare, you learn to shake beer, because you get the thought current. It's not that you just get English. You get the thought current. Just not to be influenced by the thought current. I never read English literature. Even though I don't have a mind because of enlightenment, even the words which I use to talk to all of you, first I create that consciously in Sanskrit and then translate. I continue to retain that ability consciously, so that the thought current will never be influenced by the language developers. The language I am using, English, is only a medium. I do not want whatever I am sharing, teaching with you guys, any way to be influenced by those guys who developed this language, their thought current. I am very clear, you should be inspired, impressed, influenced only by the masters, great masters who developed the language of Sanskrit. So I retain the verbal flow consciously, first generated in Sanskrit and then translated into English and shared with you all. Listen. Simply you can do it. Don't be stupid educated engineer. Still now, in our Sacred Arts department, from making the wax model to finally finishing the carving of a deity, whole thing I can do with my hand. From wax modeling to final finishing, polishing. Because I did not go properly to my diploma college. Otherwise, 3 years is a lot of time. They would have made me believe it is too difficult. In that whole 3 years, finally the fellows who come out, what they learned, you know, just threading one screw. Maybe the half inch diameter rod, they know how to thread it. That's all. That is the final project, practical examination. And that also you have a choice. God saved me and helped myself to save myself. This concept of difficulty is injected into human beings so that you can be kept as a slave forever, I tell you. Whoever injects the concept of difficulty, renounce those people in your life. You will be saved forever. whoever teaches you possible, possible, possible in your life, by giving up anything, be around them, you will be saved. At the age of 11, once I ran away to Vadalur. There is a place in Tamil Nadu. A great saint, Vallalar, lived there. I ran away. The only thing which brought me back is, if I am stuck with something, with the idea of difficulty, who will tell me it is possible and push me? Only my gurus can tell. So I came back to my guru's feet. He said, no. Who will make me understand it is possible? Only my guru can. Guru's feet is the ultimate tirtha. No parivrajaka will help leaving guru's feet. That is the ultimate tirtha. Any parivrajaka in 3 days depression. Fourth day, suicidal depression. Fifth day, depression. Only a person who constantly tells you possible, accept him as guru and never leave him. Never leave him. Possibility is his statement. Positivity is his state. As I said, Guru is the statement of God. God is state of Guru. Let your statement be possibility always, and your statemental be positivity always. Maybe a new word, it's okay. Statemental. Let your statement be possibility always, and statemental be possibility and positivity always. Let your statement be possibility and statemental be positivity. Remember, today's Guru Purnima message is Guru Bhakti. It means becoming authentic to your connection with the Guru. Becoming integrated to your connection with the Guru. Taking responsibility to align yourself with your Guru. Enriching yourself and others with your Guru's energy. Guru Bhakti is independently intelligent enough technique to lead you from step one to ultimate enlightenment, and even after enlightenment result for your life is Guru Bhakti. That is the ultimate satya, ultimate prasada. Guru Bhakti is independently intelligent enough to reach you to enlightenment. Decide today this one thing clearly, strongly, with your whole being. You will become authentic, integrated, responsible and enriching towards your connection with Guru. Whatever incompletions, karma, which is stopping you. Bring that and offer it with whatever you are offering today as Sadashiva. I commit with you all. I'll burn all those karmas and give you the greatest prasada, Guru Bhakti. Mahadeva says, Sadashiva says to Parvati, even if you see God, ask Him to give you Guru Bhakti. Even if when you have darshan of God, ask Him to give you Guru Bhakti. Because that will give you everything, and that is the result of everything. That is the first and last inspiration. Don't allow any stupid dog to do dash dash on your Guru Bhakti. You feel the dash. Don't allow any stupid donkeys to do dash dash on your Guru Bhakti. When they try to do dash dash on your Guru Bhakti, what happens to them? You can see whatever negativity they spread, their karma is coming back to them. I have not cursed them, but their karma is coming back to them. They are suffering. But finally, the fellow who lost is stupid you by letting those donkeys do dash dash on your Guru Bhakti. Do not allow any donkey to do dash dash on your Guru Bhakti. Whoever tries to disturb your Guru Bhakti does the worst thing to you. Whoever strengthens your Guru Bhakti are doing the best thing to you. Because that is the life and goal. That is life and goal. Life, goal, result. Today's message, Guru Purnima 2015 message, is Guru Bhakti. Live it, radiate it. With this, I'll move to the next segment of today's celebrations. Offerings to the world from Nityananda Sangha's various departments.
Nityanandam. Now, Swamiji is going to release the Sarvajna Pita booklet on this very day of the Guru Purnima.
Actually, this is the first brief presentation of the Sarvajna Pita project. Sarvajna Pita is the most ancient Vedic Sanatana Hindu Dharma University existed and existing, started by Mahadeva himself, is going to be now revived by his very energy, his very blessings, by himself. Even though last inner awakening I released the booklet, but the first hardbound copy, I am releasing it today to public, everyone. Earlier it was more like a pamphlet type. Now it is presented in a hardbound booklet. The first Sarvajnapita book goes to the historical, thousands now may become owners. The first owner of Sarvajnapita, Srikant and Prasanna. The first copy goes to them. Prasanna, please come and receive. On behalf of Srikant, Prasanna can receive. First person who took the step to make this into reality. Thousands may follow, are following, thousands are following. The first person who took the step, my blessings.
Now we move on to other releases. First of all, Nityananda University Press is offering at Swamiji's lotus feet the following 14 books. The first one, Secrets of Third Eye Awakening, The Science and Art of Awakening the Third Eye by His Holiness Paramahamsa Nityananda.
This release goes to the first adult who started fluently reading through Third Eye, Nitya Devi. This copy will be sent to her. She is the first adult who started reading fluently immediately after initiation. So this copy goes to her.
Next is 108 Truths of the Yoga of Enlightenment, Volume 1. Talks on Patanjali Yoga Sutras by His Holiness Paramahamsa Nityananda.
Actually, all these books today, whatever we are releasing, 14 volumes and Sarvajnapita book, all the 15 are available for free download in nityananda.org. You can go and freely download and read. As we believe knowledge is free, in a way we are also outdating all the gurus who are marketing knowledge by making and declaring knowledge is free.
Next one, Straight Solutions from Upanishads, articles based on talks on Isha Vasya Upanishad by His Holiness Paramahamsa Nityananda. The 108 Pearls from the Bliss Ocean, Essence of Nitya Satsang by His Holiness Paramahamsa Nityananda. 108 Nuclear Bombs from Nitya Satsang, a compilation of 108 Best Loved Stories from His Holiness Paramahamsa Nityananda.
Actually, you have to read the title properly. New and clear. You should not say nuclear. New clear bombs.
Next one is, what is gratitude? Essence of His Holiness Paramahamsa Nityananda's teachings on gratitude. Shanti bhakti le lo mujhe Nityananda. Nityananda.
Actually, 9/11 has two important things for US. not only the World Trade Center terrorist attack, on the same 9/11 only, Vivekananda spoke in Chicago Parliament of Religion in US. So two different cultures gave two different 9/11 to America. America, remember which 9/11 you want to repeat. One came with nuclear. Please understand, Vivekananda gave new and clear bombs. The other 9/11, you know what it is. So, America, if you want again, the Vivekananda's 9/11, new and clear, get ready.
Now, we are moving on to one more very special release, Katha Upanishad by Paramahamsa Nityananda, with English translation and transliteration in 5 parts on original palm leaves made in ashram at the Nityananda Sacred Arts University.
This is one of my favorite, I can say passionate, release about which I am very happy and proud. Thanks to our Swamis and Brahmacharis who worked for it. Now, the whole translation of Upanishads available in modern language in Eastern way. I always tell people, get modernized, nothing wrong, but don't get westernized. Here, the real version of modernized but not westernized, true Easternized Upanishadic presentation. Maybe first time ever English is getting printed on palm leaf. The Indian traditional way, especially Katha Upanishad, especially the Vedas and Upanishads, here as a 5-volume Katha Upanishad is available, and very soon you can expect all the 108 Upanishads will be available, because we ourselves have our own infrastructure to publish books in palm leaves. We have established a complete infrastructure, sourcing, processing, printing, publishing in palm leaves. It's done in-house. It's done in-house. Soon we may even start growing our own palm trees. It has come out wonderfully. It has come out wonderfully. I'm so happy and feeling satisfied. More than with any other things, I'm so satisfied with this offering, where beautifully every day you can enjoy the original verse and the translation before going to bed. Just keep it next to your bed, pick up and read few verses and translation, contemplate on that and fall into samadhi. And the leaves are also processed in a traditional natural way, so the longevity is more and user friendly. All of you can enjoy. As a 5-volume, Katha Upanishad is already ready. And it is so nice, the first copy goes to me directly. Yeah. First copy, I'm going to keep it with me. It's so beautiful. And I sincerely thank and bless everyone who is behind this whole project, making it successful. Blessings.
Now we are moving on to some e-books which are also being offered. The Upanishads source book translation in Russian, an offering from Russian Nityananda Sangha.
Nityananda Sangha Russia is offering the Upanishad source book in Russian language. I am releasing it as e-version for free download. You can see the book.
Then the Upanishads source book translation in French, an offering from French Nityananda Sangha.
Nityananda Sangha French. French Nityananda Sangha offers Upanishad source book for free download.
The Upanishads source book translation in Portuguese, an offering from Portuguese Nityananda Sangha.
The Upanishad source book is available in Portuguese by Portuguese Nityananda Sangha.
Living Enlightenment book translation in German, an offering from German Nityananda Sangha.
Nityananda Sangha Germany is offering the Living Enlightenment book in German for free download. It is available in the internet. All of you can download and read.
The Essence of Living Enlightenment book translation in Bengali, an offering from Bengali Nityananda Sangha.
The Nityananda Sangha Bengal offers this book, Living Enlightenment, Essence of Living Enlightenment. The Bengali Sangha is offering the Jivan Mukti, Essence of Jivan Mukti in Bengali. It's available for free download for all of you and read in the internet. Blessings to Nityananda Sangha in Bengal.
The four tattvas, Path to Jivan Mukti, book in Gujarati, an offering from Gujarati Nityananda Sangha.
Nityananda Sangha Baroda is offering the book in Gujarati. Blessings to Gujarat Sangha. It's available in the internet for free download.
The Living Advaita magazine translation in French, again an offering from French Nityananda Sangha.
So Living Advaita in French is available from Nityananda Sangha French.
Now we are moving on to some more releases from the Antarjala Amnaya web team. The first website, Sri Paramahamsanityananda.com, a new website about our beloved master Swamiji.
Nityananda Antarjala Amnaya Peetam is offering Sri Paramahamsanityananda.com to the world. The website is available, you can see and be blessed and use this.
Now, kumbhamela.com, site that explains the deep significance of the Kumbh at its grandeur.
As Mahamandaleshwar of Mahanirvani Akada, I am releasing the official Kumbh Mela website, kumbhamela.com, which will now give everything about Kumbh Mela. All the details of Kumbh Mela will be available in this website. You can all enjoy.
Next, redesigned and content updated, innerawakening.org, our website.
So, redesigned innerawakening.org is dedicated to the whole humanity. The team which did paramahamsanityananda.org, Ma Yoganandini, Dikshananda, Satish, Varsha, Shreya, and the team which did Inner Awakening, Ma Prematma, Nagaditya, Malayarasan, blessings to all of you. Blessings to the whole team.
Releasing the next version of N Pregnancy Care website, that is npregnancycare.nityananda.org.
Blessings to the N Pregnancy team. Come on, give a good hand. It's not a small job. They have done a very good job. You think making somebody pregnant is very easy? Come on.
Now.
Trying may be easy, not making. Come on.
The releases from Nityananda Sangeet Shala team. One more new album, Guru Vandanam.
Yeah. And this is by actually my Mahatma Purnananda. She's comparing by herself. So the first copy goes to Atma Purnananda.
Now inaugurating the official social media channels of our Nityananda Sangha, Nityananda News, news to transform your life. You can now be updated to date with news from the Nityananda Sangha on Facebook, Twitter, Google Plus and on YouTube. Anyone who wants to cause inner awakening as a reality, who has completed inner awakening can call into ask about completions. Anyone who is new to completions and wants clarity can make use of this show.
There is a beautiful show by Living Advaita by our Swamis and Swaminis. Every day after 8 to 9 AM and 8 to 9 PM in Nityananda TV, you can use this to raise yourself in the space of completion and living Advaita.
We have one more release of our website, releasing hindutemplesfromnow.com. It consists of information about top Hindu temples. As of now, 50 temples has been added. We will be continuously adding more temples there, like Tiruvannamalai temple, Kashi Vishwanatheshwara temple and Akshardham temple.
So
you see historical information.
Formally I am inaugurating the website of Hindu temples.
Now, we are, after a very long time, we are moving on to a very special ordainment. We had in the campus, all over the world, participants attending Nityananda Yoga Acharya training and also Nityananda Yoga Kids training program for last 8 days. So, the teachers who are getting ordained will be receiving
Nitya
a certificate
yoga,
from Swamiji himself.
Nitya Dhyana Yoga teachers training and Nitya Dhyana Yoga for kids teachers training. So the whole team whose names are here, I declare and pronounce the team who is going to receive these certificates as Acharyas. Blessings to everyone who has become acharyas to spread this message of ancient Vedic wisdom to the world. So with this, I bless you all. Let you all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching, causing, living Advaita. the eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you. Be blissful.
Nityananda Dhyana Peetham, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Bidadi, Bengaluru. Phone 08027279999. www.nityananda.org www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.
Welcome all of you once again. Thank each one of you for participating. As just listening itself, you contributed minutes of understand this for you listening and developing powerful cognitions inside you. A beautiful and really, really healing energy of peace flows from your heart center and reaches out healing the whole globe itself. This time, that this precious time that you invested in global peace needs to be recorded. And that's what we are doing. We are recording it. I request each one of you to record your minutes for peace you spent today in minutesforpeace.org. The link is located below. Request each one of you to take a few minutes now. Go to this link and enter the number of minutes that you spent today, whether it's in the form of puja or satsang, anywhere where you are experiencing the space of oneness. Because from that space only you share it. I request each one of you to go to this link and register it. I wanted to thank each and everyone who participated in this. Stay tuned. We'll now be entering the next segment, Dutamottama Seva. The best, the bestest of things as prescribed by Parameshwar.